All right, we should be live. Microphone looks good. Desktop looks good. Hey, so Wilds of Eldraine is out. So it's time to do a draft. Yeah, premier draft it is. Yeah, we got enough gold, looks like, where I can afford to do this. Still have enough for a draft token if it shows up. Yeah, I had a full day today before work, so I did not get the stream or Baluna. Hey, we have opened the Virtue of Persistence, which we will be taking. Look at it here real quick. I'm going to highlight it so that it takes it. Coven is not terrible. Gingerbread Hunter is really strong, especially if you're in black-green. Barrow Naughty's been okay. Beat the Cauldron's decent. Grabby Giant's actually really good. It's got a really nice curve out as a 4-3 on turn 3. If you don't have anything better to do on turn 2. But yeah, we're going to take the Virtue of Persistence. It's a removal spell, and then it is a Doomsday enchantment that your opponent deals with or dies. Yep.
So I see you're starting off great.
Yeah, I think so. Hey, this guy found the Rings of Bright Earth. Huh.
I did not realize Land Tax was one of the archive cards.
Yep. There's also the Scoundrel, who is not terrible.
Okay, she is a rare, but I haven't actually run into her yet across all the pre-releases we did.
She is not terrible. Land Tax might be too strong, though. Although, we don't get to decide if we're on the draw in Best of One. Mm. So we don't have enough control over that. Maybe I do want the Scoundrel, then. Scoundrel's a super good aggro card. Like, that is a 2-mana 2-2 haste that your opponent loses a life when she dies if you don't want either of the other two variables on her.
She is really good.
There's also the Hamlet Glutton. Like, that thing is also really strong, but I think we're going to try taking Charming Scoundrel. Ooh, a Vampiric Rites. That is great for my black-red deck. Ratcatcher, Sweet Tooth Witch, Minstrosity.
We're all actually pretty good. He's good for red-white because you can't use his thing, but he is really good.
I was going to say, he's a 3-mana 3-2 haste on the turn he comes down, and that's if you don't cast anything else alongside of him. Give that haste also. Alright, now we're seeing Agatha's Champion and the Howling Galefang, and the only red card is Unruly Catapult, so I think I'm going to take one of these big bomby green cards, and I think I like the Champion a little bit more. Like, Galefang is not terrible, but...
It was bargained at fights?
Yes.
Okay.
We'll see what else we get past. Who knows, maybe black's going to turn out to be terrible because there won't be enough black cards and I'll be really sad because Virtue is just absolutely nuts. Like, I might splash for it if I have enough things in green level of nuts, especially at 7 mana for the other half of it. Not dead yet, Hollow Scavenger, Sky Beast Tracker. She gets back an enchantment or creature. And whenever enchantment you control is put into a graveyard from the battlefield, she gets a 1-1 counter and you get to scry. That's not terrible. There's also a Torch the Tower here. Yeah, actually, Torch the Tower is good enough. Take that. Mana Flare. Probably not. Voracious Vermin, probably yes. Spider Food, also good. Yeah, okay. Give me the Voracious Vermin, then. Ah, neat. Monstrous Rage. A Barrow Naughty again. Yeah, I do like me some Monstrous Rage. I'm going to need some other creatures, though. Mm-hmm. I got, like, two creatures right now. We're not in green. And I'm sure we'll have plenty of time to find them.
But you can always wield that Unruly Catapult.
Ooh, shoot. that is a lot of stuff that I want for this deck.
I think the Trainee is overall the stronger card.
Yeah, but I would run all three of these in a black-red deck.
Yes,
so.
You would.
That is a good sign for us, though, if that's our eighth pick and we have, like, three different cards that go really well in Rats, and we're black-red, and we have some okay cards for Rats already, or just good cards in general. Anybody else we know? That doesn't look like it. We wield the Coven. Assassin's not terrible. We don't have the enchantments for Tabby right now. And now I'm going to take the 4-mana 2/3 that makes my opponent discard a card when it comes into play. Has flying.
Flies?
Yeah, it's a fairy.
So it is, and does.
Crescendo, Minecart Daredevil. Probably should just take the Daredevil.
I really don't like the Daredevil.
It's okay, it's not great. Ooh, a Sweet Tooth Witch. This one is treasure. Enters the battlefield, create a treasure. That's also not bad. If we had better stuff to ramp into besides the Virtue, I'd like it a lot more. Alright, I'm down to take a witch. He's got good reach at the end of the game to finish the fight off.
Three Unruly Catapult for a good home.
Yep.
I mean, it's probably not the best in this deck, but I've told you before, I do love Unruly Catapult.
Mm-hmm.
Even if it's not good in your deck, I just love Unruly Catapult because that card is ridiculous.
Archon of the Wild Rose.
Well, also, there's Impact Tremors.
Yeah, and Taken by Nightmares, which is what I'm going to grab here. I would love to have an Impact Tremors. This is almost good enough for me to take, though. 4-mana 4/4 flyer that turns anything
right,
else that's
God.
Enchanted into a 4/4 flyer is... Like, that thing is way better than any of the cards I'm about to take, but...
But you are nowhere close to him.
Yeah, unfortunately. Eh, well. Alright, so no red cards at all.
And barely black cards?
Yep.
He's not terrible.
He's not. There's a part of me that wants to take the Hamlet Glutton. Like, I have some decent green cards. Like, the green might actually be better than my red at this point if I take him.
Well, you can take him and see.
I could also take the Tough Cookie, who is just really good.
I really like Tough Cookie.
Yeah, so do I.
I think a lot of people actually really like Tough Cookie.
Alright, we'll take him just in case we don't see the red. Well, we're still not seeing red, and we get another Glutton.
We also get Monstrosity, Troublemaker Oof. Which one is Season of Growth? Oh, that
one. You have to target the creature to draw a card, and whenever a creature enters the battlefield, you scry one. It's not terrible, but... Alright, Stingblade Assassin, not dead after all. Barrow Naughty... Obira, just to continue to make me sad that I'm in black-red, or trying... There's a Scalding Viper. I did just notice him. Scalding Viper is really good.
He's really good even if you can't cast a spell, right? Like, just dumping your opponent every time they cast.
Every time they cast a cheap spell, it just deals them another damage. there's another rat catcher trainee. Okay.
There's also Edgewall. I still think the trainee's better, but you might want a way to pump his power somehow.
I mean, I do have Monstrous Rage so far, and the Minecart Daredevil for that.
Yeah, the pack has better evasion, but I think the Ratcatcher attacks better in general. Speaking of things that attack surprisingly well, there's a Skewer Slinger.
I might actually want the Prophetic Prism.
Also good. The Slinger did do a surprising amount of work for me, though.
Yeah, I can see that. There's a Farsight Ritual in this pack. There's a 6-pick and a Johann Stopgap.
There's Raid Bombardment
again. This time I can take it. Hey. Frantic Fireball, 8th pick. Okay, yeah. So maybe there just weren't red cards. Alright, now I have Impact Tremors and...
Yeah, no, there just weren't red cards, because there's no way someone's in red and did not think either of those were okay. Unless they were, like, green-red.
I could see that. But then they didn't take Ruby, either.
Yeah.
Yeah, my casting cost is too high for Dark Tutelage. I think I will take it for signaling purposes, though.
Oh god, if you actually flipped over the virtue with that.
Yeah, it hurts a lot. Might be green. Ooh, that was a weird noise I was not expecting for Oofs to make.
Well, I didn't hear it, so I'll take your word for it.
Mm-hmm. It's very shrill. Like, faint but shrill. Like, I'm really glad that sounded way further away.
I think the Red Cap Thief is better.
Hmm.
The Naughty is a flyer, but I think the Thief is better in general.
I do have one fairy so far.
Now you have a Thief.
Yeah, just the one fairy so far. I'll take the Ambush. Our last pick is Water Wings. Soul you Cauldron, win. Stab Wound.
You won. Congratulations.
But I really love Stab Wound.
Yeah.
Like, with all my heart, I love Stab Wound.
I love Stab Wound, too. I also love the Rat Out. But...
just out of... Oops, wrong thing. So I am highlighting the Soul Cauldron. I'm not going to have activated abilities, right? All of my things are triggers. Nope. So it's just getting counters.
Yeah, you will have... Yeah, she's not a good one. You want one. Like, you want the Tabby, actually. You want the Warehouse Tabby.
Stab Wound is so good, though.
I'm just saying you really want a Warehouse Tabby right now. You can have another Witch. You can have Rat Out. You can have Edgewall in if you want to get back one of your guys with adventures.
Right now, that's the Daredevil. Oh, wait, it's a card with an adventure, right?
Yes.
Low-key do kind of want that for Virtue, then, in case something happens to it.
Virtue's really good. You can get back your Daredevil. You can get back the,
Yeah.
What's it called? The Rat Catchers. You can get back the Elemental, too.
Have an Elemental?
The red-blue guy.
Oh, right, the snake.
Isn't he an Elemental?
Might be. Scalding Viper, Elemental Snake. Yep. Sorry, I think of him as a snake, not an elemental.
Well, he's both.
Alright, gonna take a Shatter now, because I love Seems me good. Removal over the two-headed giant. Grim Search, Feed the Cauldron, Collector's Vault, which is probably my favorite card in the set. Yeah, okay.
Mm-hmm.
It's my favorite card in the set. I'm taking it.
Also, now you can make treasures if you want to cast your off-color adventure. Or if you just want to cast your 7-drop enchantment sooner.
I really do. Keep forgetting Minecart Daredevil is considered a knight. Like, nothing about this screams knight to me.
Pretty sure the only thing screaming is the goat who's having an awful time right now. There's food fight.
There is food fight when I have the vault. Yeah. Yeah, okay. I'm down to do this one again.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, no, it seems good. Seems really good. Free edge wall pack to a good home?
Yeah.
Or the apple?
If I had better ways to sacrifice creatures... I have vampiric rites.
Pack is good. Giant's decent.
It's either pack or giant, I think.
I would go with the pack.
Giant does make a treasure, though, for food fight.
Yeah. But pack makes another creature for your raid bombardment and your impact tremors.
There's a scream puff.
Yes, there is. He loves food.
He is food, practically.
Why he's screaming.
Is that why? How many 4-power creatures do I have?
None?
Naturally.
Scream puff?
Scream puff is it.
Pretty sure scream puff is it.
Yeah, I can still cast the adventure side off the treasure.
Also, he's a 2-mana 2/2.
Well, so was the rat guy, which is why I was looking at him. That's true. That is a rat out. I'd rather have at least one of those. Okay, now I'm a little sad because I don't know that I need two of them in here. I need to make cuts. I'll take the uncommon.
Refeed the cauldron?
Yeah, I already have the vault for card draw, so I don't need the Grim Search. Thingblade Assassin would also be okay. Alright, that should not be here still. And Curse of the Werefox.
Man, the deck looks good overall.
Yeah, it does. Alright.
Is this one of those decks where you agree with me that 16 land is a good idea?
No, because I want to cast Virtue of Persistence and Scream
Puff.
Have
Collector's Vault.
Yeah? I also have Food Fight. I'd rather throw my treasures at my opponent's creatures and kill them than use them to cast Virtue.
Only because you can just discard the land to make the treasures anyway.
Rat out.
Might be the Firebolt. Does the Firebolt go to face?
No. The thing is, I think the Firebolt, for the most part, kills more things than Feed the Cauldron, and the Feed the Cauldron, the Shatter the Oath, and Taken by Nightmares can kill the things, like the Bunny Corn, if that becomes an issue.
I was thinking Feed the Cauldron also makes a food that you can throw at somebody.
Yeah, it should be fine. I have Collector's Vault. Scoundrel, McRuiner, Ratcatcher, Scalding.
I forget, did you pick up any activated abilities besides the Witch?
No.
Okay.
No, the Cauldron is entirely putting 1/1 counters on my guys when creatures die.
And whatever your
and whatever my opponent
have.
Happens to have, yep.
How many creatures are you running right now?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. These guys have spells that make creatures. 13.
Probably want to cut spells and not more creatures.
Yeah, I know. I just really like a lot of my spells.
I like a lot of your spells, too. I just don't think you can afford to cut too many creatures here.
Alright, in that case, we cut the Firebolt. And
Great Bombardment is power 2 or less.
Yes.
So most of your...
I was going to say almost all of my creatures. You know, assuming I don't use the treasure to put counters on the things. And even then, I've got rat tokens to put counters on. I'm wondering if it's Scream Puff, put the rat in back in, and take out one of the swamps. Like, lower the curve. That does make Virtue of Persistence harder to cast, but...
Not as hard as you would think. I mean, yes, there is going to be a situation where you really wish you had the extra land, but... I really don't think it's going to be as hard as you think.
Alright, so... drop that, pop down, add the rat in back in, but drop a swamp because I do need red more early on. Mm-hmm. Alright, let's try it. Super aggro rat deck, hopefully.
Sure.
I mean, it's the most on-theme thing for me right now. This is a slow hand. Only one of my cards even does anything. I guess technically I could throw the soul cauldron at something if I needed to. Alright. Hey, what have you got for me, opponent? You good? Okay. There's my swamp. Let's just go ahead and get this thing down so we have it. Hey. Do they have the fairy thing? The spell stutter? Or are they just reading this thing right now?
This is a new set. They might be reading that.
Obira the Dream Duelist.
Okay.
Yeah. I mean, she's really good. She's a 2-mana 2/2 flyer. Like... with flash and more upside, so... like, I might actually be in trouble with her. Let's take a card out of their hand, hopefully.
Oh, you took a card out of their
hand. Yeah. Alright, so I can I can Soul Cauldron onto my creature when I get one now, but I'm gonna need some stuff. That is super unhelpful on this board right now. I am getting dangerously close to throwing the Soul Cauldron at Obira to kill her. Also, I forgot to exile their spell just because there are things that get spells back in this set.
That is a really amazing one if you can get it onto one of your creatures.
I need to kill Obira, though. Also, this exiles anyway, so it's not like... Mm-hmm. Actually, I should have killed Obira last turn instead of casting Vampiric Rites, because then I would have gotten the Scry to look for more creatures. Okay.
Focus on them.
Hopefully. Hey. Ow. Still should have exiled the spell. Alright. Alright, let's get rid of Obira.
Oh, of course they do.
They do have Spell Stutter. Alright, time to bargain away vampiric rights then. I'm definitely keeping the food fight here. Yes, I would love that creature, actually. Thank you. Yeah, it's just tap to exile a card.
Yep. Oh yeah, it's amazing.
Let's get rid of Ice Out.
Too haste.
Yep. Oh, they've got four cards in their hand, so I have to believe that I'm the one that's way behind here. Let's get rid of that one.
I mean, you would think so, but okay. Why not at this point?
Nope, that's fine.
Everybody's hand is reactive?
Pretty much. Oh, mighty 1-1 rat.
I mean, it will get there. Eventually.
Eh.
And apparently they're going to bounce for that or something.
Okay. -4. Yep. Well, all my creatures now have Living Lectern's ability anyway.
Creatures. You have no creatures. Your opponent also has no creatures. I mean, that's two creatures if it resolves.
That is true. Do I want to cast them? I was debating if I wanted to cast them now and then cast the Rat Catcher trainee this turn.
They are in black, so maybe not.
Eh, it's fine. As long as this resolves, I'll get two rats and then... Yeah, that happens. Hopeless Nightmare. Well, thank God I held on to the swamp.
I mean, yes. Actually have another Ice Out that has just been holding on to this whole time?
Apparently.
So do they have one creature in their entire deck?
Also apparently. Let's get rid of Fairy Fencing, I guess. My turn. Alright. Fine.
Body it is.
Yep.
They're only going to attackers.
Yeah, that's actually super helpful.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's in black. Yeah, we don't want to get rid of the Rat Catcher trainee. I might want to get rid of the Charming Scoundrel, though. Get a counter on this thing. Oh, right. She needs a 1-1 counter before she has the activate ability. That's why it wasn't giving me the option. Mm-hmm. No, I was like, why can't I sacrifice this just in case I need to be able to sacrifice it? Hmm. Return target adventure from your graveyard to your hand. There is the one Black Wrath, but they don't have creatures in their graveyard for him. So.
Also, Picnic Ruiner is going to be
a double striker.
Double strike, yeah.
Yep.
And if your other guy wanders off, then eventually Picnic Ruiner will trigger himself next turn. As long as you remember to eat a creature this turn.
Okay. Yeah, apparently they have no creatures either. Hooray!
That was a weird game of Magic.
Yeah, it was. Apparently they were all in on Obira, because that was all they ever played. That was actually a threat to me. Then they just annoyed me for the rest of the game, once she was dead.
Oh, that is stuff.
Yep. This is a sorcery, right? Yeah.
Black red and had no one drop or two drop. Your opponent has no idea what to do here. Never mind, they have every idea what to do.
I was gonna say, they apparently know exactly what they're doing here, and everything is awful until I can shatter the oath on that thing. In the meantime, here's a 4-2. In the meantime, I'm going to try to aggro beat them down as fast as I can.
I mean, as long as they don't literally play Vampiric Rites right now.
Actually, Vampiric Rites doesn't block the 4-2.
No, it doesn't, but it does give them a way to eat their fairy tokens forever while blocking the 4-2 with it.
Until I hit 5 mana and get to get rid of the enchantment. I would actually prefer that, because then they would take a bunch of damage, and then they'd have, like, 2 1-1 flyers to show for all of it.
Yep, they're just going for it.
Yep.
I mean, that's one less torch on your edge wall pack?
Yeah, that's true, because I would just sack the token.
Mm-hmm. Mirror Blossom is a dumb magic card, by the way.
Yes.
Just in case anyone hasn't figured that out yet. In case somebody has just started playing Magic today and has never run into that card before.
I mean, I had a lot of fun with it at the pre-release.
Uh-huh.
Well, found my 5th land, so that's a good sign. Alright, here's my 3-3 Menace.
And his 1-1 buddy?
Yep.
Are they going to torch him?
I think they're gonna grapple him. This feels like Candy Grapple.
They must go, for their planet needs them.
I mean, that's one way to defeat Bitter Blossom. Just have my opponent have a terrible internet connection right now. Okay. It's fine.
What they're splashing for. I know they don't actually have to be splashing, but I wonder what they're splashing for.
Left it on top.
They didn't snap it to the top. Although that might also be a bad internet connection. Okay.
Hmm. Okay. It's fine. Maybe it's Sugar Rush. They're holding priority for something for one mana.
I mean, I guess it could be, but...
Only one more land drawn away from being able to cast Virtue of Persistence, so...
Do you make your guy a 4-4 and then see if it trades with a 4-1 fairy? I assume you need to kill Bitter Blossom.
Yeah, sorry, up to one creature you control and a Wicked Roll will be attached to it. Alright. Ooh, maybe it's not dead yet.
No, it's
Fairy Fencing. Alright, well, Bitter Blossom is down.
I did forget that was one mana.
Yeah. And they had three fairy cards to work with. Does it say fairy creature on Fairy Fencing?
Control the fairy.
Nope, so Bitter Blossom would have counted anyway, even if the tokens were dead.
Oh, right, it's from, like, the one set where Tribal actually existed.
Yep.
And is a perfect example of what a tribal card should look like. It is a tribal card of the thing it makes tokens of.
Mm-hmm. Man, these catapults are getting really unruly now. Yep, sure is.
Anyway.
Yep.
Now that they know what's coming.
Well, now we know what they're splashing for.
Yep.
Yeah, I'm gonna take a ton of damage now. Yeah, this might be too much.
Maybe?
Like, I don't have enough creatures in the graveyard for this.
Isn't it any graveyard?
Yeah. But all they've got is a catapult, and all I've got is my dog, so...
Yep. 2-2. Blocker.
And what else is it gonna do?
Okay, fine, just run it into the 2-2
It
then.
Literally does not do anything else except deal them damage here.
Really just wanted to run it into the 2-2 for a free point of damage, that's fine. I just wanted to make sure you wanted to run it into the 2-2 for a free point of damage. This would not be the first time you have ignored the card that your opponent just played last turn.
Yeah, I'm just gonna die. There's too much damage on board right now, and my virtue's way too slow against what they're doing. Especially if they're gonna trigger Celebration again off of one card. That's 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I go to 3, yeah. And now they have a 4-4, so I can't even block with the edge wall. My graveyard. Yeah. I don't have the actual wrath, so. You are too little, too late, my friend. Which is a real shame, because
because this was about to become a thing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's over. Anyway, mostly casting my rat because I can't remember what the dailies I have piled up are. So.
Unfortunate.
I think the biggest problem was that I wasn't not going to cast the virtue there because I was planning on casting it next turn, and then they finally played a creature that was super aggro and I needed to be able to kill with it the turn after. They played their 2-drop that I needed to kill with it afterwards. I almost want to name green.
You should name green. You should always name your splash color with Edge Wall. Unless you want to name blue because you're going to cast the Picnic Ruiner.
I was going to say, the Picnic Ruiner, though, is going to be my 2-drop. Hello, opponent. Yeah, he's going to be my 2-drop.
You want to name blue, then?
Alright, you've said hello to me twice, opponent. Not really, because I don't plan on casting the weird bounce spell on Steam Serpent. As much as I plan on casting 2 red spells in a turn, potentially.
Okay, right it is.
It is a shame, though, now when I get back Picnic Ruiner, I can't cast the adventure side of him.
That is the latest Gingerbrute ever.
But it's turn 2. It's not like it's the turn 7 Gingerbrute.
Well, your opponent is playing the perfect deck for you to food fight them.
Yep. Blue-red food?
Yeah, I don't know either.
I mean, yes, they are blue-red and they have played 2 food, so...
Mm-hmm.
Technically accurate.
Alright, so what were they getting priority over? Oh, right, the Ginger Brew.
The Ginger Brew activation. Alright, I'm muting you now. This is like the 4th time you said hello to me. I'm off it. Yes, it's a sorcery still.
What? It's always been a sorcery. Okay, that is hilarious if you exile their Ginger Brute with your Soul Cauldron. None of your stuff can be blocked unless their creatures have haste.
I have to pay 1 per creature, but yeah. I've muted you, opponent. You can say hello to my cards as much as you want. It's not going to do anything. They are spamming something at me right now. I just don't know what it is. Could be anything.
Probably the way.
And they love casting that divination. It's really weird that they printed divination in this set.
Mm-hmm. I don't know why they gave it a different name.
Alright. I'm sorry, I can't hear you over all this damage I'm about to deal to you. And the fact that you're muted.
I mean, I assume you're about to deal 3 damage and they're going to block the 2-1 if you attack with it. Or you're dealing 2 damage and they're going to block the 1-1 maybe?
Oh, I hope they block the 1-1. Yes, but the opponent keeps casting it at sorcery speed, Dandelion, so that, you know, it's really weird that it's a sorcery here. Because it's a sorcery here, as far as they can tell. I mean, maybe they were looking for land, but that's the only thing I can think of here. Eh, we'll wait on the Soul Cauldron and the food fight, because I'd rather use this for the food fight.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they might have legit been looking for land, or they might have been distracted by spamming hello at me for, like, the first 5 turns of the game.
I like to imagine they were still spamming it constantly.
Me too.
With 2 mana floating.
Yep. Maybe the hellos aren't for me. Maybe they're screaming it at their deck because they weren't drawing land properly and had to cast their instant speed divinations at sorcery speed to find them. And they're just like, hello, deck, can you give me land?
That's why you just shout it at your monitor, where your opponent can't hear you. That's the benefit of playing online. That's like the main benefit of playing online, besides being able to find
So it's a young
people.
Hero now?
Yes.
Hey.
Yeah, they have decided to race you.
Okay.
You food fight their gingerbread man?
Oh, absolutely. Goodbye, gingerbread man. Thanks for showing up. Or it grows out of range.
I wouldn't say a bot.
Alright, was that the card you needed? Are you greeting that card now?
It is a good one.
Yep.
Okay.
Making a treasure.
What are the other high mana cost spells?
Besides the virtues?
Yeah, are all of the virtues high mana cost?
Yeah, they're all like cheap spells, big bomby enchantments, or... Now they're gonna draw a card. Neat.
Okay. Because, yeah, other big bombing spell I can think of that they're trying to cast right now is the dragon.
Let's see. Well, I'll grab their ginger brute. Put a counter.
He puts counters on himself.
Yeah, I know. Oh, that's true. He has counters on himself, so he has the activated ability. Alright.
Also, you can eat all of your guys with the counters on them now.
yeah, I did make that cheaper. Oh, well. It's fine.
But no, seriously, you can eat all of your creatures with counters on them now.
Yeah, but they still have to tap to do that.
Yeah. I'm just saying it because it amuses me.
Hello, Living Lectern. Would you like to go to the graveyard? Because I would love to throw you in the cauldron.
Okay.
2-1, or I'm sorry, 2-2-2s, not 1-1s.
Is it going to the graveyard? Of its own volition?
It is at sorcery speed, right? Yeah. Ah, hello, Doomsday Enchantment. How are you doing today? Alright, so if we killed one of the 2-2s, the other one still blocks, the 0-4 gets in my way. So, we need to eat a creature so that the witch actually becomes a problem for them. So my graveyard. Yeah, let's eat the Hermit. Although, if we put the counter on the witch, we can just make her unblockable. That's 4, 5, 6, so I need 2 damage, which the food fight does. Okay. Ah, thank you very much for the subscription, Dandelion. I appreciate that. So, we go... Can't be blocked this turn. And... Can't be blocked this turn.
Oh,
for 6.
Scoundrel can block them.
Oh, because it has haste.
It's the only thing that can block them, though.
Well, if they don't block, then they just die. So I'm okay with that.
I did also forget that.
Yeah. Yeah, that's true.
It's fine.
Do I need to kill either of their 2 creatures? Probably not.
This
is going to buff them up, though. The 3 power.
Yeah, it's true. They are free attacks if they...
Yeah, it's fine. They're 3 power, but they're not 3 toughness. I can block the 1. Well, there's another blocker.
Yep.
Unless I kill it.
Yeah, I think at this point you're trying to kill that. Or maybe you're not. Maybe they'll have something else really scary.
Okay, that's fine. By all means. Just those two? Alright, so... I can just put the counter on him, too.
For what? From what?
From the Picnic Ruiner with the Soul Cauldron next turn, and make him unblockable.
Oh, next turn, okay.
And then make all three of them unblockable.
And then yeah. They take five?
So I just throw the food at them at end of turn.
Seems good to me. Because only one of their guys naturally has haste. And... they're probably
They can gain the three life from him, though.
They can?
They can block and sack him to gain three life here.
Do you want
to
throw the food at him?
Four, five... Ah, they have stopgap, and they sack the token.
Is he only one to eat? Is the ginger brute one?
No, he's two, but now they're getting rid of my four-power creature. So I kill this and attack them for five, and then I can throw the cauldron at them.
Yes.
So, yeah.
Wait,
okay.
Do you have to tap it to food fight?
No.
Okay, then yes.
Alright, so we kill this. Which bounces. They draw a card.
You are one land short, though, right?
Am I?
No, it's just tap to eat. No, sorry. I did my math wrong.
Okay.
I was thinking it was six for some reason.
Are we sacking the lectern to draw a card? Yeah, we are.
Okay.
Yep.
I mean, it needs to be Torch the Tower right now.
Yeah, that would kind of ruin my day. Although it would also... they'd have to sack the thing? I guess not. They could kill the rat.
Yeah.
Okay, so go to my turn.
Well, if you were one land short, you have a land now.
Alright, so you activate the cauldron.
Yep.
Eat their other ginger brute.
Mm-hmm.
I guess I could have eaten living lectern, too. That might have been better.
Yeah, I think it's fine to eat the other ginger brute.
Alright, put the counter on him.
Oh, apparently they have it. And they're sacrificing the recruiter for it?
They can't. It would have to be... they'd have to sack the enchantment off of the 3-3 is what they're doing. Yeah, it is Torch the Tower, and they did sack the enchantment. Alright.
Oh well.
Yep.
So, play the witch?
Yeah... I think I also kill the 2-2 Vigilance now. While I can. Because I'm almost at the mana to cast this anyway.
Yeah, because you don't
And it takes them
right
off
now.
The... takes them off of being able to sack a token now, so they can't bargain anything they draw.
Maybe it was correct to try and kill the token before that? I don't know.
Yeah. And ship the turn back. Ooh, I'm a high fey. Look at me doing important high fey things.
Didn't it mock you by squeaking at you?
Maybe. So, time to cauldron again. Because this isn't getting any less silly. Now we eat the lectern. Put a counter on the witch. Can't be blocked.
Okay. Someone has had enough of this game. They have realized they lost.
I'm pretty sure they realized it a while ago. They were just hoping I would misclick and eat one of my rats, I guess. Or my witch. Yeah, just eat my witch. She's made out of delicious gingerbread, apparently. Alright.
I mean, that... Wasn't that how she died in the story?
Yeah, she was shoved into her own oven.
Oh, this is a hand?
Eh, I got an early removal spell. I'll take a card away from them. They're mulliganing on the play. Yeah, okay. Seems fine. Okay, they're green, and their first creature has ward.
Of course it does.
But other than that, everything is fine here. We're all fine here. How are you doing? It's fine. I can kill it before it gets the counter on it anyway, so... I'm more concerned with, yeah, they have a monstrosity, which that I will actually kill here. They can have their food.
No, they can't.
Oh, right, it exiles. I keep forgetting Torch the Tower exiles, like,
Torch
on its
main thing.
Torch the Tower
is just amazing.
Yeah, it is. Alright. Time to be wicked and attack for damage.
Seems like a plan.
Well, fortunately, they have an oof and not a fairy, but also that's going to get in my way for a little bit.
You can just attack and see if it gets in your way.
Yeah, it's true. See, the Ratcatcher trainee is implying that I have something they might not block.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they don't want to lose it to rat out or something. Alright, we'll just pass the turn back. Because now they'll have the fourth land to buff up their thing. Leyline of Abundance. Well, that's going to be a problem if they ever get to 8 mana. Oh good, they're attacking me.
Okay.
Yes, let's trade damage here. That is the absolute best thing for me, because now I'm going to take the last card in their hand, and this is going to be great. This is going to be wonderful. I'm having a wonderful time here playing Magic the Gathering with my opponent. I hope they agree.
And it is...
Garrick's Uprising. Eh.
I mean, not great on this board. They have a 1-1 and a 1-3. Not great on this board.
Nope.
They have a 2-2 and a 1-3.
Yep. So they have Uprising. Right, I exile... All my stuff exiles except for this thing. So... exile target creature. Yep. So they can...
Probably want to get rid of the 1-3?
I do have an enchantment. Yes. I do get to scry, too, which is very tempting. The other option is to kill the 1-3 so I can play the Soul Cauldron next turn if I draw a land. And still Taken by Nightmare as another creature if they draw it.
I mean, they have no cards in their hand. You're trying to kill them as fast as possible.
Yeah.
And this would put a wicked roll on
my creatures.
Rats?
Should probably be the fairy, actually, because that's the thing they can't block once I kill it. And they can eat a 1-1 here and take 6 damage. Yep, yeah, okay. This all seems reasonable. What'd you draw, opponent? Is it a good magic card?
Oh, they're stopping to consider how to use it. No, it was not.
Neat. Poor opponent. They're never gonna know I had Agatha's Soul Cauldron. If they had waited a turn, they could have blamed their loss on that. They could have been like, I was doing great, and then my opponent played Agatha's Soul Cauldron, and they had a bunch of creatures, and I had a dead creature, and it just went really badly for me. Their friends will be like, yeah, that card's ridiculously bomby. Instead, now they have to say they lost to, like, the fairy that made them discard a card.
So anyway.
Yeah.
Drops all the way. That's true, the Scoundrel is just small enough for Impact Tremors.
No, this is Impact Tremors. This is just creature comes into play, deal damage.
Alright, sorry. Thinking of Raven Bombardment. You have so many...
Do I want to loot with this hand?
More importantly, do you want to risk the Wicked roll on Rat out?
Hmm. I could also just make the treasure token and guarantee playing, like, the Red Cap Thief next turn. Or I could play Impact Tremors first, and then start casting creatures. If I don't hit a land, then I'll know I need to loot for a land. And she'll still deal damage when she comes in, and possibly on the attack. Well, so she's not getting through a 1-3.
Comes in.
Well, now we can just play a 4-2 that can attack. Or a 2-3, make a treasure. Yeah, we'll play the 2-3.
So what does the spell score do on the spell side?
Oh, it's returns a spell to owner's hand. It's a remand.
I mean, that is actually really good.
Nothing. Well, nothing is pretty interesting. As is this monstrous rage I just drew. Alright. I'm down for a 2-2 haste now. Yeah, it's true. I probably don't want to... I could minecart Daredevil, though, to kill it here.
Yeah, I think you're okay.
They haven't cast anything besides this thing, and it's a mana dork.
Hmm. What would they be getting priority for, then? I mean, it's up to you if you want to try and kill it, but...
I really kind of do.
Alright. I mean, the worst that happens is you find out what their trick is.
Could be pretty bad, though.
As long as it doesn't kill your creature?
Okay.
Yeah.
Yep, that works. Yeah, if it was Candy Grapple, I would have been in trouble there. Although Sugar Maw is kind of a beating, too. Ah, they played a 4-4 instead.
4-4 haste. Vigilance.
Oh, right, because Sugar Maw is on an adventure. Well.
That's awkward.
That's fine. Look at him, guys. Yeah, okay. Kills that one. Cauldron out. Ooh, I can make all my guys mana dorks that have counters on them. That's actually not terrible here. But I'm stuck on 3 lands. Because I do want to take it by Nightmare, this 6-6.
You're only saying that because, oh my god. Yeah, I don't think you want to... I don't think you have time to run into the.
No, I was thinking, do I want to risk them having the roll that saves this thing?
It doesn't save that, you're exiling it.
The one that gives, the royal treatment.
Oh, royal treatment.
Hexproof and then makes it a royal token, or makes the royal enchantment.
That's not in black, though.
They're black-green. I don't, I'm debating if I want to let them untap.
Oh.
Yeah, I do want both of those, and I want the mountain first, so I draw my land next turn. Yeah, alright. Because then I can cast this coven. Yeah, okay. Demon gets to be wicked.
He's feeling very evil right now.
Yeah, it's fine. Please discard a card.
land.
Yep. Alright. None of my things have abilities because none of them ever do. And they only have the Gale Fang. Yeah, we can wait on it. Since I've learned from playing against you, I can activate this at instant speed to get counters on my guys, even though they don't normally do that very often anymore.
Only saying that because I saved, what was it, Toten Taunts with that?
Yeah. Yeah, it was bad. That was so bad.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, they have Stormkeld Vanguard.
Imagine that.
Alright. Well, I'm still gonna eat your guy and make my coven bigger. Since I might need to be able to block your Stormkeld Vanguard now with my creatures. Okay. Now my guys aren't mana dorks anymore, so that kind of sucks. Yeah, let's deal them a damage.
More damage?
At the cost of taking two? Yeah, probably.
I mean, maybe you'll make them eat that food at least?
Alright, so I've used Taken by Nightmares, but I haven't used the Oathbreaker thing or whatever it's called yet, so that'd be really nice here. Oh, they didn't attack for two. That is actually kind of surprising here. Two, three, four, five. Like, part of me just wants to kill the 2/2, because then that leaves them with the 6/7, which technically I can kill right now. Mm. Both of my creatures can block it. This way I don't take extra damage. Yeah, let's play the land. What's the other option? I attack them for 3, they go to 8.
They attack me for 6,
I go to 7. And then I need one more point of damage? Alright, now I like it. Let's do that. Let's force them to have things here.
I mean, they probably do. Yeah, that is a lot of thing to have right here.
Yeah, it is. Stops my guy. Yeah, I think we need to do this, find something else here.
Do you need to find something else, or do you just want to discard that Raid Bombardment and be able to cast Virtue next turn?
At that point, I probably want to discard that so I can cast Virtue next turn, but I was looking for something else, but I will being able to cast it. And no attacks now, because that will stop the witch from attacking me also, I think. No, it won't? No, because they definitely should attack with the witch, because if I double block... If I block the witch, I have to block the Stormkeld and not trade for it. Otherwise, they can throw the food at me before damage, mm-hmm. and then the witch dies, and I take an extra 2 and just drop, so... They should definitely attack with the witch, too. Also, if I have to block the Stormkeld, then I can't cast Virtue next turn, because I still die to the witch. So.
Well, if they do nothing, you're in an amazing spot.
I can't imagine them doing nothing here.
They have
to attack me.
I can't imagine them doing nothing either. I think they're trying to figure out how bad each of these options goes for them. Because if they don't attack with the witch, then you have enough time to do something in theory.
Yeah.
And if they don't attack with anything, you just play Virtue and then you're going to win. Okay. Like, you are winning this long game now.
Yeah, I have the Thief and the Scoundrel in yep. my graveyard.
And they have nothing, but that's okay. You're getting all of your creatures back forever.
Yep. I don't know how they didn't attack there. I don't know what was in their hand, but... like, everything I had was on board, so... okay, that sucks for me, but...
yeah, that's unfortunate.
Especially since I can't revive that one specifically. Because it won't be a three-power creature anymore. Oh, none of them will be three-power. I can get back the Daredevil to guarantee a block on the 6-7.
And then you can play the trainee.
Yeah. It might be what I have to do here. They're at 8. Yeah.
Also, that is going to kill them. That's really nice.
Yeah, it is. Right, we just cast her now?
Just cast her, that'll put them to 6. And I think you can just pass the turn here.
Yeah. That gives me a tiny bit more wiggle room against them. This is only 2 damage from the food, right? I'm looking at theirs as though I don't have one of my own. Alright.
Because if you actually make it to the end of their turn, then you can play out the pest problem for 2 more damage. Also, if your witch dies here, that's amazing for you.
Yeah. Yeah, they can't attack me anymore because of the witch. Alright.
Pest problem.
Alright, now I like getting this one back to take a card from their hand. That's fine.
So is there any reason not to just attack all here? Because only 1 point of damage needs to get through, and the witch will eat the food to kill them.
What if they kill one of... what if they kill this thing? Then the... they block, they still take 1, they go to 2.
And the food kills them.
But they also have a food. Like, I think it's close.
Well, you can also play out your 2-1 and threaten the activation of yours whenever.
That's true. Should I draw first? If I'm gonna do that anyway?
Yeah, because he's only 2 mana.
That's neat, but it's not exactly what I need here. Though I can cast it and just have it out and technically active with the treasure token. Yeah, I think I hold on to it. I'd rather have the activation on the witch or the food. I still have that, but...
yeah, but... that's fine.
Maybe they... I was gonna say, maybe they eat their food out of desperation here. That'd be hilarious.
I mean, they don't... like, what are they gonna do? Kill your witch?
They might. The scariest thing is the werefox that has the adventure that puts a monster roll. Because then they can give trample to the Stormkeld. Okay. Yeah, that was the one card I was most worried about.
Yeah, all I could think of is, like, what are they going to do? Kill the witch here to stop you from activating the food that just gives you the witch back with another food?
Mm-hmm.
And then you can, like, you can use both of your foods, so that way when they go to eat theirs in response, you just kill them.
Yep. Nice and easy. just the way we drew it up. Attacking with rats. Playing rats and attacking with them. That's how we won that game. And the rest of the cards, yeah, sure, they contributed, but... Hey. Ah, it's a Rabbite. We're playing Secret of Mana.
Speaking of...
That is a lot of rats.
Nothing. Speaking of absolutely nothing related to what you were talking about with your joke...
Okay. Yes, opponent, I have rat out. You can tell by the arena tells. You should not play a one-toughness creature here. Should I play a one-toughness creature here?
I mean, you do have the other one for when they play a one-toughness creature. Don't know if it's correct to play him, but I think it is.
I think it is, too, to curve out. Yeah.
Yeah, especially since you're not guaranteed to draw your third land. Land.
Alright, if they used a premium removal spell on that, well, then I'm good.
That's not your third land.
No. But in some ways, it's better.
I was going to say, but it will be eventually.
Also, my opponent's missing an entire color, and now I get to discard and draw here.
Joke's on you, they're mono white.
They might be.
Just wanted to hold up the mana so that way they can exile your guy when you go to sacrifice the enchantment somehow that you don't own.
Alright. I mean, this is going to be a problem when they eventually draw their other color and start deploying spells, but in the meantime...
I gotta be honest, when they actually had nothing, I think I would have just exiled the creature there.
Gets +1/+0 on lifelink.
Yeah, he's pretty good.
Yeah, that might be worth killing with Taken by Nightmares, but I don't have an enchantment right now, so I don't get to scry. Still might be worth doing it, though, just so they don't gain life and so I can keep attacking. Or I can deploy threats.
Do you want to use the Collector's Vault before the Witch if you're deploying threats?
Not really, because then I have to sacrifice the treasure I get off of her. Alright, let's take him out. It seems like it'll be problematic with how I'm currently winning this game, if they can suddenly gain a ton of life. Like, if they put down another big blocker, I don't really care as much.
Or, you know, if they do that. If they have that ready to go.
Alright, Well, their thing is first strike on attacking, so...
Mm-hmm. Yeah, blocking is awful on this board state. Do you want to use Pest Problem then, Train?
Yes.
Okay.
Alright, now I just need my Raid Bombardment, and I think they explode. Like, I think they might actually explode.
5, and then you have 6 damage coming in. Yeah, basically.
Well, look, there's their merry band. Yeah.
That is not surprising at all.
Nope. Yeah. I will take 4 here. Or 5.
Mm-hmm.
Mm.
That is a good one.
Yeah. See if I draw anything else I want to cast, though. Or an extra land that I can discard. Well, now I kind of want to discard her and play the Voracious Vermin out.
And then torch the tower. Ooh, do you want to see which rat token they block and then torch the tower with that? Unless they block the Charming Scoundrel.
I was just thinking I'm okay if it grows my Voracious Vermin right now.
I still think you want to torch the trainee.
Oh, torch the trainee before it gets the third counter?
I mean, if it gets the third counter, you can sack the rat for it. You can sack the rat for it anyway, just to get the extra counter on your guy and scry.
Oh, they're going to torch my guy now.
Never mind.
You
won't get big enough.
They didn't... All right, you still only have one toughness. Is creature, right? Enters the battlefield, this creature can't block whenever another creature you control dies. Okay, so that happens. He gets exiled.
Unfortunate.
Alright. I want to wait and see if they attack with their 3-2. Like the other 3-2, the bards themselves. Because right now they're actually really far behind, so if they're attacking with the trainee, then I can kill the bards and they have one less blocker here.
It's presenting 6 damage right now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I don't think they can actually attack here is the issue. And if they do, then killing their one guy might just be enough to finish them off. I guess I can attack with the rats. Okay. Alright, so that rat's a hero now, too.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think killing the trainee in response to his trigger is a good idea.
So I want to see if they attack with the bards first. If they attack with the bards and the trainee, I will kill the trainee. Definitely. If they attack with just the trainee...
Right now you only have 3 damage coming back at them. And I have... I honestly don't see a reason why the rats wouldn't be attacking, so that's going to be for 4, 5, 6, 7. I mean, there is also always the chance they just have it. And this is about to be awful.
Yeah.
No, I was wondering what it was that it wouldn't save their thing, but that makes sense, actually. 4, so... Get off the guards here.
Yep. Them off the table. 2... It was dangerously close to being lethal there, actually.
Mm-hmm.
4, 3, 2, yeah. Dangerously yeah, no, close to being lethal, off. But... Probably still not exactly what I wanted to be doing. Oh! Well, shit.
Oh, that's a mythic. They're going to shoot your Daredevil down. I assume. It's 2 mana to deal 1 damage.
To deal 1 damage.
Yeah, I assume they were going to shoot your Daredevil down because that is by far the most damage on board.
Now, do they attack me with both? Because a dragon can attack.
Nope.
Alright.
If you take this, the dragon is lethal next turn. And I'm not
I mean,
sure
the
how
dragon's
you deal with the dragon.
Pretty lethal regardless. I still have the other removal spell in the deck, right?
Yes.
I still have the 5-drop. Although I would have to draw it naturally off the top. But I don't know how I'm beating the dragon otherwise. The other thing is that they only have the 1 blocker, so that puts them to 3, so I need 3 damage.
All right.
Which raid bombardment would be. Four, five, six, seven exactly. Yep. Alright. So,
raid
bombardment or bust? No. And none of mine do. If I could kill that dragon, that'd be awesome. Yeah. Yeah, there's nothing that's gonna... I can put a counter on one of my guys and deal them... So, 3 damage down to 2, but...
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, unfortunate. None of my things, like, even if I got back...
No, it would have only been 2 extra points.
No, I punted.
Did you?
Yeah. Yeah, I punted that. She's 2 mana. I could have gotten her back instead with the thing. And...
With the thing. What, with the Soul Cauldron?
Right? Oh, no, I'm sorry. It's
no, that
1,
cost
2,
way
3.
Too much.
I was 1 mana off of being able to do that.
Okay.
Yeah, okay, I got it. Never mind. I thought I had exactly enough mana, but it's because I activated that I had the treasure.
Yep. Edge rolling is good, but it's not that good. Also, you're still 1 point of damage off. They were at 5.
Right, they block 1, 2... Oh, no. Yeah. I'm thinking it's like, okay, I just needed the extra couple points of damage. Okay.
Nope. Really close, but...
This is why I have a math fail emote.
Yes?
It's specifically for that reason. I don't know what it is about Arena why I can't do math properly. I do it much better in paper. When I'm constantly staring at all the cards.
Hey. Is Arena failing to read your cards for you?
Probably. Get on that, Wizards. yeah. Vampiric Rites does nothing.
And you can't even play the Viper.
I can't play the Viper yet. It's amazing if I hit the mountain, though.
Oh, yeah.
Like, I get to go Rites into Viper into Witch.
Mm-hmm.
And then one land unlocks these two. Yeah, I'm not feeling that one. Alright, this is better. We will keep this. I think we put that on the bottom, since it's the hardest one to do anything with right now. And we try and Picnic Ruiner into Minecart Daredevil.
Hello, Warehouse Tabby.
Goodbye, Warehouse Tabby. I think.
I think that might be correct, but I don't know if it's correct
this
turn.
To do it right now. Alright. Let's cast him down, then.
Because, yeah, now...
Maybe they hold up a land to give Death Touch.
No, they are attacking
They're
straight
attacking
into
with
you.
It. Okay. That's fine, then. Come down.
Who's their blocker?
I don't need a blocker.
They didn't seriously think you would block with the 2-2, did they?
It's a new set. It just came out today. I might have. I mean, that's a better target, and it gets me through damage. The other option is I can attack first and try to ride the rails to kill their 2-1.
Sure.
So I think I'm going to do that first, because they might just go easy block here. Okay. Hey, this is fine. Let's rat you out.
They have ride the rails.
Maybe. If they do, it'd take a ton of damage here.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm also missing land drops, so...
Oh, nope.
Oh, whatever they had, which might just be the Tabby activation.
He said he didn't see that just happen.
Mm.
It is, once again, almost your third land.
Yep. Alright. Getting in there. I'm debating if I just want to run out the trainee right now. Instead of the vault. And try and hit the land naturally for Minecart Daredevil.
Might be correct. Just race them.
Hey. Okay. That's fine.
I mean, that was killing whatever you had anyway.
Yep.
Oh, good.
So I want to 5 them this turn by just casting this. Right?
What?
While I control a 4-power creature gains double strike.
4, 8 Oh. I thought you were going to ride the rails and make your picnic ruiner a 4-power creature.
Hmm. That might have been better then. I just wanted to get the 4-2 down, but yeah, that might have been better. If I draw a swamp next turn, I probably kill them.
4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 currently?
Uh-huh.
That's weird, they're holding back... Why are they holding back the 2-1 and not the Death Toucher?
Not the 1-1 Death Toucher? No clue.
I mean, that's 2 damage.
Do I want to give them a 3-2? Eh, probably not.
That is 2 damage incoming and you're winning
this race. Oh, hey, it's a swamp. So, anyway, I started killing their stuff. That went to attacks awfully fast. Okay.
Oh, those don't block.
No, they don't.
3, 6, 9, 12 Alright!
Alright, you got me. Alright, we both tried to do the thing. If I had drawn a land like a turn sooner, that would have been alright. But oh well. We got to 4 wins, so that's pretty good for our very first draft on Arena. Oh yeah, let's go open some packs and see what we got. Ooh, fancy animations.
Okay.
Begone cards. We got Grass Fate, Emodane. Raid Bombardment, Crown of Winter. Oh no, I have to click Dismiss cards. It will not... You used to be able to just click anywhere.
I don't know, were people too impatient and just kept clicking through it?
Maybe. Charming Scoundrel again.
Also, are you only getting 8 cards out of this?
Yes, but that's normal for Arena packs. Huh. Hey, look, it's my commander that I'm currently building around. Oh, Baluna. Are you... There's a Utopia Sprawl. Raging Battle Mouse.
I'm still annoyed that there are mice in this set.
It does that when it's a rare. Hilda's Crown and Polluted Bonds.
Woo-hoo. Okay then. Hey. Yeah, no, I'm still annoyed that there are mice in a set that has a heavy rat sub theme.
Well, that's going to do it for this draft, so thank you for watching. We'll throw Raid over to Octo real quick.
Oh, sure, he was doing a Tana party today.
Yep. Go ahead and do that. Thank you again to Dandelion the Bard for joining the stream and for the subscription, and I will see you next time. Have a good rest of your day. Go Rat, or Raid. Yes, go Rat also, but go Raid, go!